Welcome to Monday with Michelle on Out Late But Great. This week we have a very light topic. We've had some heavy topics over the past couple weeks, so this is very welcomed. A viewer wrote in and told us that they were having trouble with their Gaydar. So that brought up the whole topic, and I'll put the whole topic below, but the gist of it is there Gaydar? How does yours work? Because they think theirs is broken. And share any funny stories or interesting stories about anything that made you go, hmm. So, you know, it's funny because I don't think that my Gaydar is very good, or at least I didn't think that it used to be. And I think, though, now that I'm actually out and have been for over 3 years now, this past month, I don't know why I didn't mention it, and I alluded to it prior, but then I skipped it when it actually was there, I think, is all the stuff that was going on with my dad. But on October 2nd, I celebrated my 3 years coming out, and God, I can't believe it's been that long. So now that I'm out and I have a lovely partner, we're, you know, inevitably out and about sometimes, and I'll lean over and I'll whisper, "Do you think that person's family?" Now, for those of you that may not know that term, when you refer to anybody else in the LGBTQ community, we oftentimes also use the word family. And, you know, so I'll lean over and say, you know, "You think that person's family?" And she'll go, "Oh, yeah." So inevitably, whenever I say that, Kirsten always agrees. Usually, I mean, I can't think of a time when I asked her and she didn't. So I think my Gaydar is working. However, it's a very hard thing to pinpoint why you look at a person and you feel that way. Because, let's face it, not every lesbian looks like this. Not every gay man looks like this. And as we know, not every transgender person looks like a drag queen. So, as far as the bisexual and people who identify as queer, there's really no good pictures for that, because they're probably the least hard, it's probably the least easy ones to pick out. So, you know, it's just like, it's a gut feeling. I don't know, maybe it's an energy that the person gives off. I can't even, like, pinpoint certain things. Like, sometimes lesbians will wear certain kind of earrings, but, you know, it's never the same all the time. You know, you have the lesbians that look very sporty and look very athletic, and you'll go, "Oh, that person's probably family." But then when you look at our next-door neighbor, who looks like that, you know, just the shorts, the little polo shirt and her little shoes, you'd swear that she was a lesbian, but she's not. So you just can't tell by looking always. I can't speak for how the men are going to talk about how they can identify other gay men. So I'm looking forward to that. And I'm also looking forward to hearing how transgendered and transsexual people feel that they can spot each other. Now, the one thing that I will say, I've seen quite a few transgendered people in Sarasota, and the ones that I've seen that catch my eye are usually ones that are probably mid-transition and who do not pass very well. But for the male to female, sometimes they're really, really tall, because some of the really, really tall men transition, and you don't see a lot of 6'3" women walking around. So sometimes that is enough to catch you, and then once you start looking, sometimes you can tell. But there are some women, transgendered women, who I've seen who you cannot tell at all. So, you know, who can say? You know, and most of the time, I look extremely feminine. Now today, I don't know, my hair is tied back in a bun. I don't have any makeup on today, but like if you look at our wedding photo, you would not think that those were two butch dykes getting married, you know. And as far as the lesbian community is concerned, you know, there's an array of different identities within even being lesbian. Everything from really hardcore Diesel Dyke to soft butch to, you know, somewhere in between that to super feminine. And many of us kind of fit into all of that at any given time. But usually I'm pretty feminine. So it's just, who can say, you know? I'm really looking forward to hearing what everybody else's answers are, because aside from your stereotypical, you know, the pictures that I showed, it's more of just a gut feeling, or maybe the way the person looks at you. Maybe we can just sense each other. It's very, very nondescript and very, very hard to pinpoint the exact reasons why you feel that way. So there you go. I know it's not very helpful, but there, that's my experience. So have a great week, everybody. See you next week.